Good afternoon, everybody. This is my first time coming to your church and enjoying this wonderful, wonderful week of your missions conference, and it's been pretty fantastic. And the music, the ministry, the hospitality has been fantastic, and we so thank you very, very much. My name is Oz Ramkisoon, and this is my wife, Sandra. Now, let me explain to you the name Ramkisoon. People, when they ask, your name is Ramkisoon, but you have a name Oz, what's up with that? Because I come from a Hindu background. My grandparents came from India and migrated in Trinidad, West Indies. And so it's strange to have a name like Ramkisoon and then have a Christian name. So you have to go through the whole process of explaining it to them. So Ramkisoon means Ram Krishna, or Ram like a Ram Dodge, kiss, coming home soon. It comes from two of the highest gods in India, Ram Krishna. So that's my name. And I've been in Florida for about 37 years as a pastor. And just recently, the Church of God at the General Assembly just appointed me as a World Missions Rep, Associate Missions Rep. So now my job is no longer the pastor, but to travel all over the country and raise money for missions. And so I'm very excited about this new position that the Lord has given to us. Your pastor and I go back to since college days, and I gave him a haircut one time in college, and so he blames me for what has happened, you know. And so we have been friends for so long, about 40 years, and this is the first time we were able to work together, And so I am so impressed by what God is doing here. And I told him he has one of the best hidden secrets in Florida. He took me and showed me your facilities, showed me everything that is going on. And I said to him, why don't we know what's going on here in this church in the state of Florida? In the state of Florida, the Lord has blessed me where I was able to work in the state level, on the state council, as a regional bishop, and now the Lord has blessed me in the position that I'm in. And we've never heard of what you all have been doing. And I said, they need to know what you all are doing in this state, because you're doing something pretty, pretty, pretty fantastic. And so I want to say to you, thank you very much for what you're doing. I am a product of missions. My father went, as a little boy, went to watch a movie. He never heard of the name Jesus Christ before, didn't know who he was. He was told that don't you ever have any dealings with the forbidden God. And so one Good Friday, he walked down the mountain, went to a movie house, thinking he was going to see Errol Flynn or John Wayne in a Western. And the movie was The Life of Christ. And he said that, I've never heard of this God before. I've never seen him. Who is this God? And it was taken from the Holy Bible. So he went the next day trying to find out what is this Holy Bible. And he told a gentleman the story of what happened, that this God became his hero while he was watching the movie. And why isn't our God as good as this God? And the man explained to him and said, my dad that night went to bed and he said he couldn't sleep. And he said, I don't know who you are, but would you quit bugging me? And whoever you are, I accept you. And so when my dad began to tell him the story, he says, Ramkisoon, you're saved. You're saved. And my dad said, saved? I don't even know what saved means. But if this is how it feels, I want to keep it. And so that is where I came from. Amen. And so in 1966, my dad was brought to America as an evangelist. They were sending missionaries outside of the country. And my dad, the state of Georgia, brought my family, all of us, 9 kids. And my dad was a tremendous evangelist. And if you can imagine, in the deep south, a dark Indian guy spacking the houses out in the deep south, you would not believe it. But everywhere my dad went in Georgia, he ministered the gospel and people were saved and filled with the Holy Spirit. And he's gone on to be with the Lord now for about 2 years. But our whole family came to America. And so isn't this pretty ironic that me being a product of missions, pastoring in Florida for all of these years, and now I'm going back to my roots, being a missions representative. I give God thanks. Amen. But if you would give me the liberty this tonight, and I asked the pastor if he would give me the liberty, if you would give me the liberty tonight to bring the pastor and his wife to start this service. This is the last night of the week for this conference. If the pastor and his wife and the leadership team would come, they have been given and given and given. And I think we've got a row of pastors here and some more pastors here. If we can all come together and if we can pray, because the work that they're doing and the stress in pastoral ministry is unbelievable. I did it for 37 years, I know. And if we can get them to come on up here, and for the leaders down here, and if we can get some of the leaders of the church and the pastors, would you help us? And let's pray for them, that this vision that God has given to them, this ministry that God has given to them, this is only the beginning of what God can do. And I really believe, to start this service off tonight, that this conference will double the next time around you come. And so would you help me pray tonight? Would you please stand and let's stretch your hands towards this leadership team? Brother Tillman, where are you? Can you just lay hands on them and let's pray tonight? Would you help us pray tonight? Father, we love you. And we bless you. We give you worship and praise and thanksgiving for your blessings and benefits. And as we start this mission service tonight, I pray the power of the Holy Spirit that's already here will envelope every one of us. I pray a special blessing upon our pastor and his wife and the leadership team of this church. The wonderful things that they're doing, the lives that are being changed, The ministries all over this world, people, their lives are being transformed by the work that they have done and what they're doing. And I pray, God, a special anointing upon them. Give them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And may this church double and triple. May this church not only be a lighthouse outside of this country, outside of this community, but it'll be a lighthouse in this community. And so, Lord, I pray that your hands will be upon Wings of Faith, that wherever people in this community hear about Wings of Faith, they will know that it is a church of passion and compassion and love and care. And I pray, Father, that this church will double and triple and will grow, not only physically but spiritually, in the name of Jesus. So I bless him and his wife, and she's quiet, and sometimes people don't know what she goes through as a pastor's wife, but I pray a special anointing upon her and Brother Smoot and his family and all of the leaders of this church. We bless them in the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. Well, all of those of you here tonight who've always wanted to sing on a praise team, tonight is your night. You are the praise team. Would you stand again? Let's worship our God together, lift our voices, and just sing of his greatness tonight.
I've been looking for peace of mind. Weigh me down. Wish I could break through that ceiling and find my way out. When I can't catch my breath and there's nothing left to hold on to, oh, I'm holding on to you. The sun is gonna rise once again.
Yes, it will.
And your promise. This is the hope that I believe in. All of this trouble I've been feeling, it won't weigh me down. I'm gonna break through that ceiling and find my way out. When I can't catch my breath and there's nothing left to hold on to, I'm holding on to you, my Lord.
And I like this part.
And though my strength may fail, I know my heart is held by you. I see a new sun rising. All of this trouble I've been feeling could never keep me down. 'Cause your grace is my healing, and you're here with me now. When I can't catch my breath and there's nothing left to hold on to, I'm holding on to you.
Sing all of this trouble.
And all of this trouble I've been feeling could never keep me down. 'Cause your grace is my healing, and you're here with me now. When I can't catch my breath and there's nothing left to hold on to, I'm holding on to you. Your beauty that's been shown, for your mysteries unknown, for the miracles we've seen, we praise you, Lord. For the story of your love, for the wonder of your blood, like me. So I'm never gonna stop, never gonna stop lifting up my hands to you, lifting up my heart. When the last day comes and goes, time will be no more. I'll be praising you. No, I'll never let it in, I'll just begin it all again. Shouts of thankfulness and love I'm always gonna give. A thousand years from now, before your throne of grace and power, that's been shown, for your mysteries unknown. How it is, we praise you, Lord, for the story of your love, for the wonder of your blood. How it makes the sinner clean. Just make it louder, shout your name on high. No, I'm never gonna stop, never gonna stop lifting up my hands to you, lifting up my heart. The last day comes and goes, the time will be.
Gathered into your house, God, to worship.
And here we are, lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do as we praise and worship your holy. Lord, you are here. answered prayer, for always being there, for love that hears us when we call, for arms that lift us when we fall. You have always been right beside us, leading us all along the way, and we've made it through because of you. And here we are, oh, we're lifting our hands to you, Lord. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do as we praise and worship your cannot see, and for all that's yet to be, the trials we may have to face, when we'll be leaning on your grace, it will be your strength that saves us, your love that makes us strong. Sing this song. Here we are, Lord, we're lifting our hands to you. Lord, here we are, giving you thanks for all you do as we praise and worship your holy. Nothing worth more that could ever come close. No thing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. Tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what I long for, to be overcome. Your presence, Lord. See, there's nothing worth more. Nothing worth more that will ever come close. No thing can compare. You're our tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves. When my heart becomes free and my shame is undone in your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place, fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome. Your presence, Lord, in your presence. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us
to what you have for us, God, withholding nothing, but yet offering everything to you tonight, God. Let us truly become more aware of your presence, God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We just thank you for your presence is here tonight, Lord. Thank you for allowing us to come into your presence. Thank you, Lord, for your indwelling presence, your abiding presence.
Thank you, Lord, that you come where you're wanted. Lord, we say to you from the bottom of our hearts tonight, Lord, we want you. We want your presence in our individual lives. We want your presence in our church. We want your presence, Lord, in our communities. Lord, for every pastor that's here in this house tonight, Lord, I believe I can speak on their behalf. Lord, we want your presence in our midst. We need you, Lord. Like Moses, when he declared, if you don't go with us, if your presence does not go with us, I'm not going. Lord, the task that you've given us, the great commission that we're gathered here this week talking about, engaged about, preaching about, none of it, Lord, will make a bit of difference if it's not by your presence. If your presence doesn't go with us. So, Lord, we recognize that. We say again to you, Lord, we want your presence. More than anything, Lord, we want you and your presence. We love you in this place. Thank you, Lord, for all that you have done these last few nights. But, Lord, we're here for a new night. There are people here tonight, Lord, that have not been here all week long. It may be their only service. Lord, we pray that you would speak to them in this house tonight. Lord, that let them be gripped with a new burden and a new passion, Lord, for serving you and for serving the world in which we live. Speak to hearts, Lord. Call people tonight. Call young people, Lord. Call middle-aged people. Call our elderly, Lord. Give us renewed passion and burden to serve you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. Hallelujah. 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 Could you just lift up your voice to the Lord and just love on him for a moment? Just tell him how much you love him.
Welcome to night four of our conference. It just keeps getting better and better, or gooder and gooder, depending on how you want to say it. Tonight, we're going to hear from four more mission entities. The first will be Mike and Kathy Maddox with Harvest, thank you. Harvest Juvenile Ministries. They will tell you about what they do here in Marion County and across the state. Then we will hear from Bob Geisel with his ministry at The Rock, called The Rock at Lake Weir High School. And then thirdly, you're going to hear from one of my favorite missionaries. My daughter, Erin Jones, and her friends from University of North Florida. They are CRU, C-R-U, part of Campus Crusade for Christ's U.S. Ministry Division. And then, as you've already been told, Pastor Alex Portobedov and Yakubu Adul will be ministering to us the coup de grace for the night. Amen. We're looking forward to it. Thank you so much for being here again. Mike, Kathy, come on up. We'll get this thing started.
Well, welcome to night four. Praise the Lord. It has been great. Before I get started, I'm going to do something here real quick. I don't have any videos to show you. So, our kids, if you're from the age of 18 and down to 5, would you stand up, please? All over the house, from 18 to 5. I want y'all to look around. I want you to look around. Now, this is a beautiful sight. You can be seated. Thank you. But what if you see them like this, with handcuffs behind them? You would not be applauding. This is what I deal with every week. From 18, and I've seen 18 down to 5. I've seen them in for armed robbery as young as 11. You know what's so sad is this. We see the kids in our churches, but we don't want to go see them when they're behind bars. I sent out some emails, and I'm not through. I've sent out 45 pages of emails going out to pastors and ministers. There's like 117 pages. So I'm not quite through it right now. Talking about risk kids. What are we doing about the problem? I'm sure if Brother Kevin was up here, he could tell you all about it as well. Because he knows about when these kids are trying to do something to the schools. We hear about it all the time. But we're not doing nothing about it. Just like Road versus Wade. We sat back on it until now we got abortion. Are we going to sit back and allow the crime among our youth continue to get worse and not step up to the bag and do our job? I've been doing this over 40 plus years. I love what I do. I serve as a state volunteer chaplain through the Department of Juvenile Justice, and I am the chaplain for the Marion County Juvenile Detention Center. I see a lot of kids come and go. A lot of parents come and go. Some of these kids are returning back to foster homes because parents no longer are wanting them. The hardest thing is, I can't hardly get recruits. I can't get volunteers. I'm going to share my heart. I've got 10 minutes. I'm going to share my heart. He said, man, this don't sound like a mission conference, but I'm telling you my heart because I'm telling you what I see. And we're all guilty because we don't get involved. How many of you in here, raise your hands, have not led anybody to Christ this year? We got hands going up. Shame on us. If we're a Christian, we're supposed to be a soul winner. If you don't have a place to go, come see me. I'm trying to get pastors and churches all over the state of Florida to get involved, because after talking to a couple of my staff there at the detention center, they said the biggest need that we are needing is good outside help. And I can't get them. There's plenty of work across this nation. There's plenty of work across the world. But we don't get involved. We say, let somebody else do it. But we don't get involved. Let me tell you something. When I was 2.5 years old, the cartilage in my right hip completely perished. The doctor said it would be humanly impossible for me ever to walk without some type of assistance with my legs. I was in tractions for about a year. I was in a full body cast for about a year. And I was in a full leg brace on this leg. And this foot built up about like this because this one was much shorter than this one. At the age of 11, 12 years old, they took the braces off and I began to walk, and they count as a miracle. Now, I was not raised up in a Christian home. I've been in a speech class ever since, from elementary all the way through high school. And when I first started, I said, these kids aren't going to even understand me. I'm going to take something else, too. When I was 15 years old, I was molested by a dear friend of mine. I know the reason why these kids need help. But if we sit down as a church or as churches and not do nothing, we're not going to see anything. Folks, I encourage you to get involved in ministry. And you know, I do all this volunteer. I travel all over the state of Florida, sometimes outside the state. And I do it all volunteer because I love boys and girls. I see girls in there that are pregnant. I've had boys in there as young as 16, 17 years old, already has 2-3 children themselves. I see parents all the time don't want to have anything to do with their kids. That's the type of kids that we're dealing with. There is wanting somebody to come in to say, I love you. I care for you. If you're interested in helping some way, after service, see me over here at my table. My goal is to win these kids no matter what. And we have committed, Harvest Time Juvenile Ministries has committed to help these kids any way that is humanly possible. If one needs an airplane ticket to go someplace, we're going to help them. If we don't, nobody else will. Only the world will help them with the world. But only we can help them with Christ and let them know that somebody cares, somebody loves them, and somebody wants to do something. I'm going to do my best to get into the schools here in Marion County and do a proactive meeting with these kids. Pray that that door will open for me. Then once this door opens for me, then I'm going to encourage churches outside Marion County to try to get involved with their kids in their schools in their county. Do one county at a time until we take the whole state of Florida. My ultimate goal is to see juvenile ministries throughout the United States. And we can make it happen. I want to say thank God for 335 kids, boys and girls, that has been saved so far this year. And I want to say thank God. Thank God for giving me such a wonderful wife that supports me. Amen. Without a good wife, I couldn't do it, church. I couldn't do it. And church, thank you for your support. God bless you.
The Rock is somewhere you can go to feel safe. They don't judge you over there like most of the other students do. The Rock is also really helpful if you need school supplies, notebooks, food for your family, and clothing.
My friend's house was lost to a fire, and The Rock provided like food, clothing. The Rock means a lot.
If you feel like nobody's listening to you, you could always go down to The Rock. There's always volunteers down there who will listen to you, sit down with you, and talk with you.
It's gonna be there for you. It's gonna be what you need. I mean, you're gonna go there a lot.
It's a real need for all these schools to have a Rock. And sometimes you might not see it from the outside. When you're in there and you really talk and you listen to what these kids really have on their heart, that's when you see the needs met.
So we have 4 Rocks open. We're about to open up our 5th and 6th this year. And the Rocks are a room that we have at the school property. And we provide food, clothing, hygiene, feminine hygiene, school supplies, and mentorship. These students are our future. These students need to be loved on. They need to be invested into. And we really, really need your help.
Praise God. Well, I'm Bob Geisel, and that's Rondo and Toby Fernandez. Before we start, I'm going to tell you that first person that spoke in that video, that was a girl. I don't know if you knew that or not. She had her head shaved because that's what her parents did because she had lice. And they shaved her head a couple times. That was just the first time. She had been through a lot. But anyway, that's one of our girls we've been ministering there to at the school. But let's backtrack a couple of years.
if I can get through these lights here. Let's backtrack a couple of years. And I had been at the school. I'm a teacher out at Lake Weir High School. I've been there about, well, this will be my 14th year coming up. And I've done Fellowship of Christian Athletes and ministered to the football players, basketball, baseball, you name it. And just been praying for God to do a work at Lake Weir High School. And about 2 years ago, went to a concert here locally and met up with Rondo. Didn't know who he was, and basically we talked a little bit, and we got together, and there was a whole bunch of other business partners that got together and wanted to do something at the school. We really didn't know what to do. We knew there was a need. Lake Weir High School, 70% or more are on free and reduced lunch, and there is a real need there. So we prayed about it. We met several times, and we actually followed a model that was done out on the West Coast at one of the high schools out there. This is not something new. They don't call it the Rock, but it's not a new thing, but they did it out there. And we watched that video, and it totally just changed that school completely. That school was getting ready to close because it was just so bad. But one of the things that happened in that video is the church got behind that group that went in there, and the church sponsored that organization that was in the schools with everything they could do. So that's what I'm asking you to do tonight. Now, we have five of these open. We have one at Lake Weir High School. We have one at Forest High School. We have one at North Marion High School. We have one at Bellevue Middle School. We have one at Bellevue High School. And as Mike Maddox told you, the door is opening. The door is opening for us to go into our schools. We have teachers there that are willing to help. We have you coming in during school hours, Christian people, during school hours, helping these kids and loving on these kids. And that's neat. That is, I've never seen that happen before. And I think you all need to be aware of that. I mean, you know, we have Christians in the schools every day working with our students and helping them. And that's what I need you for. I need you to come and help us, partner with us to help these kids of Marion County because they really need help. Now, last year, this church did a wonderful thing. We 200 some turkeys we did for Thanksgiving. And we had 250 families that need food for Thanksgiving. And our church donated the fixings and 200 and some plus meals for these students. We're coming up on Thanksgiving again, so I'm sure that we're going to have the same or more that are going to need your help. So that's what we're looking at doing. So how do we make a difference? When the kids come to us in the morning, we just do our best to love on them and show them God's love the best way we know how. We have the things that they might need there, the opportunities for them to talk to us, the things they're going through, the struggles that they're facing each and every day. I'll be honest with you. If I grew up, as some of these kids did these days, with the problems that they have, I don't know if I'd make it. So I really don't know if I'd make it. The parents don't. Some of them, the parents don't want them. I've got a kid that was in my class this year that's living in his car. You know, these are the things that are going on. So I encourage you, as Mike has encouraged you, we're on the front side of that. We can get them before they get into trouble. We can help them and show them the right way before they get to Mike. And let's do that as a church. Pastor Matt encouraged us last night to go to run the race. It's time, church. It's time. It's time for us to reach out into our communities. It's time for us to go and make a difference in our schools and in our local community. So I hope that you can continue to partner with us. I thank you for all that you've done up to this point. But we need your help. If you're interested again in getting involved, all you have to do is fill out a volunteer form. You don't have to buy a plane ticket. We're only 10 minutes away. And we'd love to have you. Thank you.
Hi, good evening. It's very dangerous to give a smoot a microphone. but they keep doing it every year. I am so pleased to be with you again. This is, my husband is not with me. I'll explain who these folks are in a minute. But this is our fifth year being partners with Wings of Faith as as missionaries in Jacksonville, Florida. I grew up in Wings of Faith, or Ocala Shores Church of God, if you're that old in the room. And so it's a joy to come home every year. My husband, Joel, couldn't be with us. We're tag teaming. He's home with some sick kids. I'm here with the well child. And so we just tag team this time of year a lot. But like my dad said, my name is Erin Jones, and my husband Joel and I, and we'll have some pictures kind of floating in the background as we're talking, just showing some of our students. But we work with the U.S. arm of Campus Crusade for Christ International, if you're familiar with it by that name, or CRU in the United States these days. And our ministry is specifically is to the University of North Florida in Jacksonville, just 2 hours down the road, to the 16,000 students that are there on that campus. So Campus Crusade for Christ started 60 years ago on one campus with the vision to reach tomorrow's leaders today. And now it's on. Now it's in 191 countries, and so it has been transformational in my life and my husband's life when we were in college. And so we have the joy of journeying with college students. Our motto is to win, build, and send. You heard it last night from Matt, to win lost students to Christ, to build them in their faith, and send them out to do the same. It's the Matthew 28 model of go, build disciples, and send them out, right? Teach them what you've been taught. And so doing that at the college level looks a lot like doing life at a very deep level together. It requires a lot of vulnerability on our parts and the students' parts for us to go very far together. Matt used the beautiful illustration of passing the baton and running that race. And I'll take it one step further. And you know how every year at the Summer Olympics, when we see the track races and you see the runner fall and somebody stops to help them finish the race, right? Discipleship looks a lot like that sometimes, is where you're picking somebody up and carrying them for a good portion of that race, and you're doing it together. That's the body of Christ coming together and pushing each other forward in our weaknesses, and we need that in the body. These are two of our more recent graduates, and so I'm thrilled for you to be able to see and hear from some of the fruit of your investment in our ministry over the last 5 years. I don't just have stories for you this time. I have living, breathing objects that you've literally poured into. And Andy and Brooke, look, I brought notes, but I haven't even looked at them. Andy and Brooke started at UNF and in CRU like the very week that we reported to campus. So we have known these guys for the last 4 years. And talk about spiritual transformation when you've got somebody who's just willing and longing to go deeper with God, but they don't know how, or they might not have the tools to, and coming alongside them and just being a healthy place where they can explore that and pushing them to go further. That's what it's been like doing life with these two. And so I'm excited for you to hear from them. And so much so that they have let God change their future plans. And they are joining CRU as staff and will be sent down to Miami to the 76 campuses in South Florida, where there are 500,000 college students and less than one of them are connected to a church. So that is a vast mission field, not very far from us. And so as much as I'd like to keep them home as a spiritual mother, I must pass the baton and they must leave. But I just wanted to take the great opportunity to introduce them to you, to let you hear their story and how your literal monthly support for the last 5 years has kept us in the field, has kept us resourced, has kept us, you know, the ability to stretch and do things and stay healthily funded. Your prayers and support have invested literally into these two. So without further ado, so Andy and Brooke, if you would just share with us what was life like before CRU, before that season of life where you came into UNF and CRU, God began using CRU to impact you guys.
Hi. Before CRU, I was kind of just this very lukewarm Christian. My family identified as Catholic, so I identified as Catholic. And just kind of didn't have a lot of community. Like, I knew that I was, that I believed in God. I knew what Jesus did, but I didn't know how that affected me personally. So I just didn't have other Christians that I grew up around. Kind of had just no guidance in learning scripture for myself. So just kind of like floating there for a while.
Yeah, for me, when I came to UNF, I had been a believer for 2 years at that point. And I was a very lonely believer, because all my friends did drugs and, you know, in the hookup culture, and I am letting that go. So they didn't want to hang out with me anymore, and I didn't really know how important community was. So, yeah, just 2 years on my own, and it's crazy how crew like impacted me more than those 2 years in just a couple months, even, because I was just learning spiritual truths that I never caught.
So just take a second to kind of like go deeper, because the idea of college ministry, it doesn't translate always super easily in terms of what that looks like, what we're teaching students, and specifically for you guys, like what were the depths of the places that it took you and the things that you've learned and how that transformed you?
Yeah, just kind of like how Andy described, kind of just the first like couple of months in crew for me was explosive, because kind of going from never hearing what it meant to live by the Spirit, to all of a sudden just knowing what it meant to trust God, going into scripture for deeper for myself and with other people that love Jesus and were passionate about sharing their faith with others, just being surrounded by genuine love and that real community that I've never had in my life before, just took me way into like the middle of the ocean of my faith. And I just knew what it meant to trust God and to actually walk in faith. And it was super exciting. And I was understanding what that adventure it was to walk with Christ, and just how to even just go to him for everyday decisions, and how to just take action in my faith was super, super cool.
Yeah, for me, without getting too deep into my story, my senior year of high school, I did leave my dad's home and just started living somewhere else. And I didn't really feel like I was wanted or cared for. So the family that I was staying at, they were going to church, and, you know, they took me to church. And I don't remember what the preacher said at all, unfortunately, but I did hear Matthew 11 where Jesus invites you. He said, like, if you are heavy, laden and burdened, come to me and I'll give rest to your souls. And that's where I came to Christ. And when I came to crew, I saw how in community, it could really be like a family. You know, God could really love you through people. And every time I think of Aaron and Joel, I think of 1 Thessalonians, I think it's 2 verse 8, where it says, you know, we loved you. We didn't just give you the gospel of God, but we gave you our very lives. And they really have. In so many ways, I feel like they are part of our family, because they've just done so much far beyond what you would expect from someone who ministers. It's been really powerful in our lives. So thank you for that. And thank you all for being a part of that too.
Yeah, thanks. I know you're going to talk about me. You weren't supposed to do that. y'all know I ugly cry when it starts to happen last year. I wanted to give you guys a taste. I'm so glad that they were able to come, that they're in the season of raising their funds. You know, like so many of us who are on the field have been in those seasons, and pray for them, if you will, if you want to talk with them more about what they'll be doing. And they'll be taking the ministry that we do in Jacksonville that they've been brought up in and changed by and replicating that, right? Just teaching what they've been taught in Miami, and hopefully soon, you know, they can't go until they're fully funded. And so pray for them as you think about us, and take a sheet off the table back there to pray for them and lift them up and encourage them. And if you want to learn more about those things, definitely talk with them. But your partnership changes lives. That's been very evident, even in just the two people who've spoken before me. The way you give, the way you pray, the way that you go changes lives every single time. Whether you're there with us or not, you are making an impact. And there's no limits in the demographic that we work in. There's no limits to where college students will go. They are going all over the world when they leave us, and our desire is that they are 100% sent on mission wherever that is. We love it when they turn to vocational ministry as a spiritual mom. You know, it means so much. But we want them to live on mission regardless of where God is calling them to go, and they're living a vibrant and active life. They're not living for the two-car garage and the picket fence and the diploma. They are living for Christ and looking for where he's going to take them next. That's our heart and our desire, that they would get out of that I'm a student first mentality and wonder what adventure God could have for them instead. So thank you, and I'll quote Paul. Every time I think of you, I give thanks to my God. Whenever I pray, I make my requests for all of you with joy, for you have been my partners in spreading the good news about Christ from the time you first heard it until now. And I am certain that God, who began the good work within you, will continue his work until it is finally finished on the day when Jesus Christ returns. And what an awesome day that will be when all of these ministries that you have heard and seen, there will be a floodgate of people that you have impacted by your giving and your going and your praying and your encouragement, that you won't be able to count the faces in the room. And so I look forward to that day when you get to experience that, for sure. Thank you.
Прежде чем я буду проповедовать, я бы хотел помолиться об исцелении.
So before I would preach, I'd want to pray for healing.
Мы должны были прилететь в ту субботу.
So we were supposed to fly in here last week Saturday.
Но мы потеряли свои билеты.
Well, somehow it happens that we lost our flight.
И пока мы ждали возможность купить новый билет.
So while we were still waiting to buy new tickets,
мы поехали в одну церковь в Москве.
We went to a different church in Moscow.
Чтобы там послужить.
Well, to minister there.
И Бог исцелил там женщину.
And God healed a woman right there.
Can you switch on?
And so we're going to see that right now.
Она пришла с костылями, она не могла сама идти.
So she came up with walking, you know, with aids. She couldn't walk.
Но после молитвы она полностью ушла.
So after we prayed for her, she
сама,
she walked by herself without any assistance.
Иногда, когда ты теряешь билеты, Бог может тебя использовать, чтобы исцелить человека.
You know, sometimes situations happen that you may lose your flight or your flight ticket, but God is going to use you to heal someone.
И сегодня у нас есть свидетельство об исцелении.
And today we already have a testimony of someone who has been healed. So I'm just going to give him the microphone to say that himself.
So we were sitting here the other day. I don't know if y'all can hear me. I can't hear myself. So we were sitting here this afternoon, and the whole time I'm praying, praise and worship, my back is just killing me. I've been doing a lot of stuff, been building my own. Sorry. Can you hear me now? I've been building my own apartment for the last couple months, down on my hands and knees, doing tile, doing wood floors, lifting concrete, doing plumbing, digging my own septic, everything. And my back's just really been bothering me over the last couple months. So tonight I was standing here, and I'm almost in tears because my back's been bothering me so bad. So after we started loving on each other, I sat down, and I was like, man, my back is really bothering me. And Alex turns and says, what? I said, my back is bothering me. It's hurting me. And he's like, well, where's it hurting at? So I show him where it's hurting at. And as soon as he said that, I said, God, you're going to heal me right now. I know you are. So he puts his hands on me, and we start praying. And I told Alex afterwards, I said, you know, we always expect healing. When somebody prays for us, we expect that God's going to heal us. But when it happens, we're always shocked. And the second he took his hands off of me, I was like, okay, let me stretch my back. It's bothering me. And I went to turn. I went, that didn't hurt. Oh, that didn't hurt either. Hang on a second.
Hallelujah.
What is going on? My back, I'm telling you, my back hasn't felt this good in months. So we had a conversation today at my house. About healing and how we always want to see healing. And the only time we ever really see it is in these mass revivals that travel around the country. And it's the Benny Hinn's of the world. And, you know, that's the only time you ever see it. But it can happen in our church if we just have the faith that it'll happen. And we'll step out and say, God, please heal me and show me.
Hallelujah. Я думаю, что сегодня многие должны получить исцеление.
So I believe that a lot of people would have that healing today.
Но у меня есть слово знания конкретной группе людей.
But I have a word of knowledge for a specific category of people.
Я хочу попросить встать, если это возможно, или сидеть, просто поднять руку тех, у кого болезни, суставы, связки, кости.
So I would want to ask you to stand up or probably raise up your hand if you can, those who have problems or pains with the joints, with the spinal cords.
Колени, может быть.
Maybe their knees and kneecaps.
Встаньте,
and the back. If you can stand up, you can stand up. If you can't stand up, you can just raise your hand sitting down.
Представьте себе, если бы сейчас Иисус стоял перед вами.
So can you imagine if Jesus Christ was standing right before you right now?
И он сказал, я хочу исцелить.
And he told you, I want to heal you.
Что бы вы почувствовали после того, как бы он сказал вам?
What would you feel after what he would have said?
Что бы вы почувствовали?
What would you have felt?
Радость, радость.
Happiness, isn't it?
Joy.
Joy.
Он бы еще не исцелил вас, он просто сказал, я сейчас.
He probably wouldn't have healed you yet, but he would tell you, he would have told you, I want to heal you, and then you will feel joy and happiness.
Попробуйте почувствовать это сейчас до того, как вы еще это получите.
Now, can you be able to try? I mean, imagine you want to feel that even before you've been prayed on.
Потому что Иисус сейчас здесь, и он хочет исцелить.
Because Jesus Christ is here right now, and he wants to heal you.
Я хочу попросить тех, кто стоит рядом с этими людьми, ну, кто сидит, чтобы вы положили на них руки, спросили, где у них болит.
Now I want to ask you, please, if you're standing or sitting right close to someone who is standing up in need of prayer, can you ask them where exactly it hurts and put your hands right there if it's okay.
И мы помолимся.
And they will pray.
Okay. Если к вам никто не подошел, вы можете сами себе положить.
Well, if nobody has walked up to you, you can put your hands right where it hurts you.
Но есть одно условие. Есть одно условие. После того, как мы помолимся,
condition.
Вам надо попробовать сделать то, что вы не могли сделать.
Now, under one condition, when we pray, you should try to do what you weren't able to do before now.
То есть, как Иисус говорил, возьми свою постель и иди.
So Jesus Christ said, take up your mat and walk.
Okay, let's pray. Иисус.
Jesus.
Мы благодарим тебя за твое исцеление.
We thank you for your healing.
И мы приказываем этой боли уйти.
And we command this pain to leave.
Мы приказываем связкам, суставам, костям и мышцам восстановиться во имя Иисуса.
We command all muscles, all joints, back and bones to be healed.
Колени будьте исцелены.
Let your knees and kneecaps be healed.
Спина будь исцелена.
Let your back be healed.
Позвоночник будь исцелен.
Let your spinal cords be healed.
Плечи будьте исцелены.
Let your shoulders be healed.
И пусть сегодня хромые ходят.
And let the lame walk today.
Во имя Иисуса Христа.
In the name of Jesus.
Аминь.
Amen.
Теперь попробуйте сделать то, что вы не
могли
сделать.
Now try to do what you weren't able to do before now.
Почувствуйте, что происходит.
Just try. Let's see what would happen. Let's feel what would happen.
Okay. И если потом, если у вас будет исцеление, вы потом можете засвидетельствовать об этом.
Well, if you have a testimony later, you can come up with that.
Но уже мы можем похлопать Иисусу за то, что он сделал.
But I think now we can put our hands together for Jesus because he has done something already.
Okay. Бог исцеляет сегодня.
God heals today.
Бог делает чудеса сегодня.
God does miracles today.
Практически каждую неделю в нашей церкви у нас есть свидетельство Божьих чудес.
Almost every week there's a miracle happening in our church.
Okay, я начну проповедовать.
So I'll begin to preach. Just a second.
Okay.
I still want to do this. Cool.
Ты уверен, что это работает?
Let's see. Once bitten, twice shy.
Окей, давай прочитай просто из Библии Деяния 28.
Okay, so if you read up with me, I'll be reading from Acts 29. Oh, sorry, 28, from verse 1. So you can turn on your Bibles or your gadgets. Good. Now Acts 28:1. Acts 28:1. After we.
До 9 стиха.
From verse 1 to 9, after we were brought safely through, we then learned that the island was called Malta. The native people showed us unusual kindness, for they kindled a fire and welcomed us all because it had begun to rain and was cold. When Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and put them to the fire, a viper came out because of the heat and fastened on his hand. When the native people saw the creature hanging on his hand, they said to one another, "No doubt this man is a murderer, though he has escaped the sea, justice has not allowed him to live. He, however, shook off the creature into the fire and suffered no harm." They were waiting for him to swell up or suddenly fall down dead. But when they had waited a long time and saw no misfortune come on him, they charged their minds and say that he was a god. Now the neighborhood of the place where there were lands belonging to the chief man of the island named Publius. He received us and entertained us hospitably for 3 days. It then happened that the father of Publius lay sick with fever and dysentery. And Paul visited him and prayed, and putting his hand on him, healed him. And when he had taken place, the rest of the people in the island who had diseases also came and were cured. They also honored greatly. And when we were about to sail, they put on board whatever we needed.
Аминь. Аминь. Давайте вместе скажем, стряхни это.
So let's say it together, shake it off.
И сделаем так, shake it off.
Just do it, kind of shake it, yeah.
Моя проповедь так и называется, shake it off.
So that's the message, that's the label of the message,
shake
it off.
Даже если вы не поймете, о чем я говорю сегодня, просто запомните, стряхни это.
Even if you don't understand anything I'm going to talk about today, just remember this.
Okay.
Yeah, shake it off.
Скажи соседу, shake it off.
Tell your neighbor to shake it off.
Okay, thank you. Апостол Павел был самым великим миссионером.
Now, Paul was the greatest missionary.
И апостол Павел для всех нас пример.
And he is an example to us when it comes about missions.
До того, как Павел начал служить Иисусу, он был убийцей.
Now, before Paul became a minister of Jesus, he was already a murderer.
И он убивал таких, христиан.
And he was murdering, he was killing Christians.
И когда он шел в Дамаск, чтобы сажать их в тюрьме, убивать, он встретился с Иисусом.
So when he was on his way to Damascus to kill them and put them into prison, he met Jesus. He had an encounter with Jesus.
Иисус определил все его призвание, всю его жизнь и цель.
And Jesus helped him understand his purpose and his calling.
Павел в Галатам пишет об этом, что когда Бог призвал меня, то я не советовался с плотью и кровью, но я пошел в Аравию, в Аравийскую пустыню, провел там 3 года.
Now, it says, Paul says in the book of Galatians, when God called me, I did not kind of have an advice with my body or blood, but I went on to do what God has called me to do.
И в Аравии он провел 3 года.
And he was there for 3 days.
Years.
3 years, sorry. Yeah.
Потому что он хотел, как апостолы, Петр, Иоанн, провели с Иисусом 3 года, он хотел также провести 3 года.
So he wanted to spend the same 3 years, how other apostles, as Paul and others, spent the same 3 years with Jesus.
Поэтому прежде чем начать служить, он провел 3 года в пустыне с Иисусом.
So he was in the desert with Jesus for 3 years.
Потому что самое главное в служении Иисусу – это сам Иисус.
Because the most important thing about ministering for Jesus is Jesus.
И Павел это понимал.
And Paul understood that.
Он не сразу пошел проповедовать.
He didn't just go ahead and start preaching.
Он хотел встретиться с Иисусом.
He wanted an encounter with Jesus.
Он хотел глубины с Иисусом.
He wanted to go deeper with Jesus.
Мы можем потратить очень много времени, чтобы убеждать людей проповедовать Евангелие.
We can spend a lot of our time trying to convince people about the gospel.
И я как пастор знаю, что ты говоришь, ты должен проповедовать Евангелие, идите проповедовать Евангелие, но это не меняет людей.
Now I know as a pastor, we tell people that you need to know the word, you need to preach the word, you need to preach the gospel, but that doesn't change people.
И однажды я сменил тактику.
And one day I had to change the whole tactics.
Я начал учить своих людей и говорить им, все, что вам нужно, это Иисус.
Now I just started telling people, all you need is Jesus.
И они, после того, как начали встречаться с Иисусом, начали проповедовать Евангелие.
I told them that all you need is an encounter with Jesus. But after they had an encounter with Jesus, they started preaching the gospel.
Потому что, когда человек встречается с Иисусом, он автоматически начинает проповедовать.
Because when someone has an encounter with Jesus, he automatically starts preaching the gospel.
И нам сегодня нужна встреча с Иисусом.
And today we need an encounter with Jesus.
Настоящая встреча, которая
изменит всю
нашу жизнь. Encounter with Jesus that is able to change our lives.
Мы не просто должны проповедовать, потому что должны.
We shouldn't just preach because we have to do that.
Мы должны проповедовать, потому что мы не можем жить по-другому.
We have to preach because we can do otherwise.
Павел пережил такую встречу.
Paul had an encounter like that with Jesus.
Ему не нужны были пасторы, которые все время бы убеждали его, что нужно проповедовать Евангелие.
He didn't need pastors who would always convince him or force him to go preach the gospel.
Потому что тот Дух Святой, который жил в нем, он не мог удержаться внутри него и все время высвобождался.
Because the Holy Spirit that was living inside of him, he could not contain it. He had to let the Holy Spirit go out of him.
И апостол Павел получил предназначение проповедовать язычникам и однажды предстать перед кесарем и проповедовать.
And then Apostle Paul had a purpose that he was going to preach the gospel, and one day he was going to stand in front of Caesar.
И когда закончилось его третье миссионерское путешествие, то пророк Агав пришел и сказал: чей ремень я возьму, того свяжут и отведут в Иерусалим.
So while he was getting the end of his purpose or his ministry, we have prophet Agav who came and told him that if I take the belt, the rope of anyone, that person is going to stop.
Да.
Yeah, he's going to stop ministering.
Но Павел сказал: нет, я для этого и призван.
But Paul said, no, this is why I've been called.
Это то, куда я должен идти.
That is where I'm supposed to go to.
И он пошел в Иерусалим.
And then he went to Jerusalem.
И его арестовали там.
And he was arrested.
И обычно бы человек подумал: все, конец моему служению.
Well, somebody would have thought, well, that's the end, that's all.
Но когда Павла арестовали, он верил, что это только начало.
But when Paul was arrested, he believed that that was just the beginning.
И проведя несколько лет в тюрьме, его хотели освободить, но он потребовал суда у кесаря.
While he was there at the prison for a few years, he was almost freed, but he decided to go in front of Caesar.
И ему сказали: хорошо, ты отправишься к кесарю.
Well, okay, we'll send you to Caesar.
То есть, если бы сегодня кто-то из нас хотел проповедовать президенту, и ты столкнулся с трудностями, ты попал в какую-то ситуацию, но тебе сказали: мы тебя освободим. Готов ли ты идти до конца, чтобы проповедовать президенту?
Now, if someone wants to preach to the president today, and I didn't get that, еще раз. It was kind of too long.
Okay. Готов ли кто-то идти и проповедовать президенту, несмотря ни на что?
So, is any of you ready to go to the president to preach to him, regardless of nothing?
Павел был готов.
Well, Paul was ready.
Но это его привело к тому, что он оказался на корабле, который попал в шторм вследствие.
But in a result of that, he got himself in a boat that got crushed.
И вы, если вы читали Деяния, 27 главу, то вы, наверное, видели, читали об этом моменте, когда Павел находился на корабле, и не было никакой надежды. Две недели не было не видно звезд, ничего.
Now, if you read Acts chapter 27, you find that he didn't have any hope while he had an accident, he crashed in the boat.
Люди уже готовились умереть, все.
A lot of people were already ready to die.
Но Павел сказал: ангел пришел ко мне ночью.
They were giving up, but Paul said the angel came to me at night.
И он сказал мне, что он сохранит мою жизнь и вашу жизнь.
And he told me that he's going to save me, we are going to be rescued, and you two are going to be saved.
То есть в этой ситуации Павел оказался лидером.
Now in that situation, Paul was more like a leader.
И он определял все остальное.
And he decided what to do.
То есть из узников он стал главным.
So he was, as he was a prisoner, from a prisoner he became the head.
Когда темные времена приходят в твою жизнь, доверяй Иисусу. Потому when, что если ты доверяешь Иисусу, Бог в темные времена сделает тебя лидером.
When dark times comes in our lives, we should trust Jesus. Because when we trust Jesus, he's going to make us leaders. He's going to rise up, he's going to rise us up from the bottom to the top.
Нам не нужно бояться шторма.
We shouldn't be afraid of storms.
Почему? Потому что если Бог нас призвал, то значит Он и поведет нас дальше и поможет преодолеть любой шторм.
Because if God has called us, then He is able and willing to take us through the storms.
Когда ученики плыли в лодке, оказались в шторме, то они испугались и начали будить Иисуса, который спал.
When Jesus Christ and his disciples were in the ship, it was stormy and they were scared and they woke Jesus up from his sweet sleep.
Но когда Иисус проснулся, говорит: что вы меня будете?
And when Jesus Christ woke up, he said, why are you waking me up?
Они говорят: мы погибаем.
I said, we are dying. Why don't you want to do anything about that?
Он говорит: ребята, у вас что, нет веры?
He said, guys, what, don't you have faith?
Вам нужно сделать вот так. Шторм, прекратись.
All you just need to do is to tell the storm to cease.
И когда он сделал это все, прекратилось.
And when he did that, everything stopped.
Если Иисус с тобой в лодке, ты имеешь власть запрещать шторм.
If Jesus is with you in your boat, then you have the power and authority to speak to storms. And no storm can stop you. No power can stop you.
Но проблема, что мы очень часто вместо того, чтобы запретить шторму, мы торгуемся со штормом, мы боимся шторма. Но нам нужно встать и запретить.
The thing that the problem is that when we are in a situation like that, instead of us to speak to the storm, we try to bargain with the storm. We begin to fear the storm. Instead of us to tell the storm to stop and cease.
И не просто просить Иисуса остановить шторм, а самим это сделать.
We shouldn't only ask Jesus to stop the storm, we should do it ourselves.
Джанет Чессер, в начале 90-х годов, Бог призвал ее в Россию. Это член вашей церкви.
Okay, Jenna Chester, she was a member of your church. God called her into missions to Russia in early 90s.
И вы знаете, когда она начала приезжать в Россию, в самом начале, о ней никто не заботился в Россию. Ей никто даже, ну, не предоставлял жилья, она была там одна.
Now, when she started coming to Russia, do you know that no one provided an accommodation for her? No one helped her. She was there alone.
В России никто не
заботился. In Russia, nobody took care of her.
И, по-моему, в 93-м году она встретилась с доктором Баски на подобной конференции.
I guess in 1993 she met with Dr. Baski in a kind of conference like yours.
И он рассказал ей про нашу церковь.
And he told her about our church.
И она приехала в Ижевск.
And then she came to Ijevsk.
И она помогла моему пастору,
and
когда он
только
начинал.
My pastor to begin the church because he just started.
Она приезжала, учила, помогала деньгами и благодаря вашей церкви, потому что вы ей помогали.
So she came, she taught us, she helped us financially, and you know, due to your help, because you guys helped her too.
И сегодня я пастор этой церкви. Сегодня я пастор этой церкви, нахожусь здесь. Джанет уже ушла, но я здесь сегодня проповедую.
So today I'm the pastor of that church. I'm here with you. Janet is not here, but I'm here preaching to you guys.
Но это еще не все.
That's not all.
У Джанет есть племянник.
But Jeanette has a nephew.
Адам Моррис.
Адам Моррис.
Он живет в Джексонвилле.
He lives in Jacksonville.
И когда я поехал в Америку на ту неделю, он проповедовал в моей церкви.
So while I was on my way to come to America to minister to you guys, Адам Моррис was at my church in Russia, and he was ministering at our church.
Вот что вы делаете.
That's what you guys do.
Но это произошло, потому что Джанет не сдалась, потому что она не согласилась с штормом.
But this happened or is happening because Janet never gave up. She didn't give up to the storm.
И когда Павел, когда этот шторм закончился, их вынесло на берег, спасся Павел и все узники.
So after the storm, they were all rescued, Paul and all the other, detainees, I say.
И они их выбросило на остров Мальта.
So they found themselves at the island of Malta.
Знаете, сегодня там люди отдыхают, но тогда там люди не отдыхали, там были варвары.
Well, do you know, today Malta is a very nice place, a good destination to chill out.
Но тогда это было холодное место.
Then it was very cold.
Написано, что Павел замерз, и все эти бандиты и воины тоже замерзли.
It was written that Paul was cold, and every other person there, even the soldiers, and everyone who was there with him, they were all cold.
Вы можете представить, что чувствовал Павел в этот момент?
Can you please imagine what Paul was feeling at that moment?
Он сидел несколько лет в тюрьме.
So he was imprisoned.
И он чуть не умер там в шторме.
He was imprisoned for so many years. He almost died because of the storm.
Но он спасся, и его выбросил на какой-то остров Мальту.
But somehow he got rescued and found himself on an island called Malta.
Я бы на его месте просто сел и сказал: «Бог, сколько можно?»
So I think that the best thing for him to do was to start complaining to God: «How long would I have to put up with this?»
Сколько можно? То одно, то другое.
How long will I have to put up with this? It's from one problem to another.
То шторм, то тюрьма, то...
So it's either I'm in jail or it's a storm or I find myself on an island called Malta.
Бог, ты же сказал, я буду перед кесарем проповедовать.
Well, God, you said I will preach in the presence of Caesar.
Но я сижу перед этими варварами, и все, что у меня есть, это эти варвары на острове Мальта.
So I'm sitting down in the front of these natives in Malta, and that's all I can see.
У меня есть эти бандиты, которые спаслись зачем-то вместе со мной.
So I have these criminals who for some reasons, you know, they got saved like I am.
У меня есть эти римские воины, которые здесь сидят и смотрят на меня косо.
Who were rescued. And here also I have the soldiers, the Roman soldiers, they are here also looking at me and being very suspicious.
Знаете, многие из нас, попадая в подобные ситуации, мы говорим, все, конец, все, я больше не хочу ничего делать, я сдаюсь.
Now most of us find ourselves in situations like that and we say, that's all, I'm giving up, I can't do anything. That's all.
Есть здесь нормальные люди, которые хотели когда-то сдаться?
Is there anyone here, I mean, a normal person who sometime in their life they almost gave up?
Yeah? Может, здесь сегодня те, кто сегодня уже хочет сдаться?
Maybe there are some people who are sitting there right here and today they are ready to give up.
Потому что вы устали.
Because you're tired.
Потому что то, что сказал вам Бог однажды, оно не работает.
Because what God told you sometime in your life hasn't come to pass.
И Бог сегодня здесь, чтобы сказать, стряхни это.
But God today is here to tell you to shake it off.
Потому что я хочу поднять тебя.
Because I want to raise you up.
Я знаю, что ты устал.
I know you're tired.
Я знаю, что тебе тяжело.
I know it's difficult.
Но у тебя есть еще впереди много задач, которые ты сможешь выполнить.
But you have a lot more to accomplish in the future.
Знаете, апостол Павел, он всегда находил свою силу в Иисусе.
You know, Apostle Paul always found his power in Christ, his strength in Christ.
И когда они сидели там с этими варварами, с этими воинами, убийцами, Павел не сдался, он просто пошел собирать дрова.
So while he was sitting there with all the natives, with all the Roman soldiers and all the murderers, he didn't just sit down to nag, he went to look for sticks.
Просто продолжал делать что-то.
He just continued doing something.
Простые вещи.
Simple things.
Павел не только исцелял больных, он и делал простые вещи.
So he didn't only heal the sick, he lived a normal life.
Я верю, что прежде чем мы начнем исцелять больных, изгонять бесов, мы должны научиться делать простые вещи.
So before we start, or, I mean, start healing the sick, you know, raising the death, we should start to do simple things.
Просто помогать друг другу.
Just to help each other.
Просто любить друг друга.
Just love each other.
И вот Павел несет этот хворост и кидает в огонь.
So Paul was bringing this bundle of sticks and throwing them into the fire.
Знаете, самое интересное, что на этом его проблемы не заканчиваются.
And do you know, that was just the beginning of his problems.
И мы прочитали с вами, что из этого дерева выскочила змея и схватила его за руку.
So we read in the Bible that from the bundle of sticks which he went to pick, a snake came out of it and clung on his hand.
Бедный Павел.
Oh, poor boy.
Я бы на его месте сказал, Бог, все, конец.
If I was in his shoes, I would say, God, that's all.
Все, до свидания, я пошел.
And that's all, guys. That's a good night.
Сколько можно?
How much can I put up with that?
Я пытался помочь этим людям, я пытался набрать хвороста, мне надо идти к кесарю, и вместо этого на мне какая-то эта штука висит.
So I'm trying to help these guys. I went fetch wood for them. My calling or my plan, my purpose is to go to Caesar and then I'm here stuck with them.
Я удивляюсь апостолу Павлу, я бы давно сдался.
I'm kind of surprised. If I was here, if I was in his shoes, I would have given up long time.
Я бы давно просто пошел домой.
I would have just gone back home.
Меня восхищает Павел.
And you know, he really amuses me. He surprises me.
Потому что когда змея схватила его, он не ныл.
Because when the snake was right hanging off his hand, he did not cry.
Он просто стряхнул это.
All he did was just to shake it off.
Он просто стряхнул это.
That's all he did.
И продолжал жить дальше.
And then he continued.
Но вы знаете, что подумали люди, которые сидели вокруг него?
Now, do you know what the people around him thought when that happened?
Что думают иногда люди? Когда ты начинаешь что-то делать для Иисуса, и у тебя начинаются проблемы.
Now, can you imagine? What do you think people around you begin to think when you start to do something about for Jesus, and then at that moment you get yourself into a lot of troubles?
Они начинают, ну понятно.
And they said, oh yeah, yeah, we understand.
Yeah.
We expected that.
И они подумали про Павла то же самое.
So they thought the same thing about Paul.
Они стали говорить. Действительно, это человек-убийца.
And they said, yes, for sure, he is a murderer.
Потому что его, он спасся из моря, но его укусила ядовитая змея.
Well, he got saved from the storm, but he got bitten by the snake.
Он точно убийца.
For sure, he is a murderer.
И Павел действительно был убийцей.
And really, to be honest, Paul was a murderer.
Он убивал.
He killed people.
Когда Стефана побивали камнями, он стоял рядом.
So when Stephen was being stoned to death, he was there. He partook in that.
Но Павел стряхнул это.
But Paul shook it off.
Он не позволил этой лжи о том, кто он был, углубиться в его душу.
So he didn't allow that lie about who he was get hold of his soul.
Он стряхнул это.
He just shook it off.
И когда они увидели, что с ним ничего не происходит, они подумали, что он Бог.
Well, when they saw that nothing happened, now they thought that he was a God.
Знаете, когда ты просто делаешь так, когда ты просто стряхиваешь эту ложь, которую враг сеет в твою жизнь, люди меняют свое мнение о тебе моментально.
Now, when you begin to deny, reject the lie that the devil is sowing in your life, people begin to see a change in you.
Trevor. Давайте ему похлопаем.
Can we clap for him, please?
I need your help. Ты будешь Павлом сегодня.
You're going to be Paul. Put your hands together for Trevor.
Иди сюда. Вы знаете, если змея хватает тебя вот так.
So if a snake would hold you, would be hanging off your hands that way. Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Попробуй.
Now,
освободиться от меня.
Now try to get off that his hook. I mean the cling. Try to get off it. Yeah. Yeah. Try to get away from him.
Это легко.
That's so simple.
Это то, о чем я проповедую.
That's what I'm preaching about.
Но часто мы позволяем змее схватить нас очень крепко.
So, but most times we give the snake a permission to grip us so hard.
Мы позволяем яду проникнуть глубоко в нас.
We allow the venom to go deep in us.
И эта ложь хватает нас.
And that lie holds us so
враг хватает нас.
The devil gives a strong grip of us.
Тревор, а теперь попробуй.
Now try it again.
Попробуй войти в свое предназначение.
Try again. Try to get into your destiny.
Попробуй войти в свое предназначение.
Come on, try it. Good.
No, пусть попробует
идти. Okay, just try to walk. Walk to me, yeah.
Come on. Come on, попробуй идти за Иисусом.
Come on, try to go with Jesus. Try to walk with Jesus.
No, you can't.
You can't, yeah, that's
потому
it.
Потому что змея тебя слишком сильно укусила.
You know why? Because the snake has bitten you so hard.
И как только ты хочешь прорваться, что-то сделать для Бога, как только ты вдохновляешься, ты прошел какую-то конференцию, она останавливается.
So it doesn't matter how much you're trying to get free. It doesn't matter how many conferences you've been to. It doesn't matter how preaching you've heard. You are still stuck.
Thank you. Ты мне еще понадобишься.
I would need you again.
Да.
Yeah.
Но Павел стряхнул это.
But Paul shook it off.
Он не позволил этой лжи проникнуть внутрь него.
So he didn't allow that lie to get deep in him.
Да, он знал, что он натворил кучу делов неправильно.
Yes, he knew he made a lot of mistakes.
Но он не позволил этому определить, кто он.
But he didn't allow that to determine who he was.
Потому что он говорил всегда, Иисус знает, кто я.
Because he always said, Jesus knows who I am.
Иисус определяет, кто я.
Jesus determines who I am.
Не люди определяют, кто я.
Not people determine.
Вы знаете, мы очень много слушаем людей и то, как они говорят о нас. Но пришло время слушать Иисуса и то, что Он говорит о нас.
We listen or hear so much about what people, their opinions about who we are. But it's time for us to focus on God's or Jesus' opinion about us.
Люди всегда будут говорить, ты не сможешь это, у тебя это не получится, ты сумасшедший, так нельзя верить. Но Иисус говорит, нет, ты сможешь, нет, у тебя получится.
People would always say, it's impossible, you shouldn't do that, you shouldn't do that, it's not right to believe that way.
Я недавно был в одной церкви, буквально месяц назад служил, и я молился за одну женщину, которая пришла с костылями, она не могла ходить.
About a month ago I was in a church, and I prayed for a woman who came with crutches, and she couldn't walk.
И она 10 лет была в таком состоянии.
For 10 years she was at that same position.
Я помолился за нее.
I prayed for her.
Она оставила костыли.
She kept down her crutches.
И она побежала домой.
And she ran home.
Побежала домой.
She ran home.
По-моему, она даже не дослушала мою проповедь. Не дослушала мою проповедь.
She didn't even wait till the end of my preaching. She ran home.
Она побежала на четвертый этаж.
She ran home and climbed up the fourth story building, the fourth step.
И везде она радовалась, что она исцелена.
And she was so happy that she was healed.
Но на следующий день она позвонила пастору.
But the next day she called the pastor at the church.
И сказала, пастор, прости меня.
And she said, pastor, sorry.
Я опять не могу ходить.
Forgive me, I cannot walk again.
Я подвела Иисуса.
I'm sorry, I have disappointed Jesus.
Я подвела церковь.
I have disappointed the church.
Я не удержала моего чуда.
I know, I didn't hold on to my miracle.
И эта ложь стала проникать внутрь.
Now that lie sank into her.
Я сказал пастору, поехали к ней домой.
And I told the pastor, let's go visit her.
И мы поехали к ней домой.
We came to our house.
И когда я зашел в ее дом, я увидел кучу амулетов языческих.
So when I came to our house, I saw a lot of
idols. Yeah.
Yeah, idols.
И я почувствовал в своем духе атмосферу, демоническую атмосферу.
Now I felt it in my spirit there was a demonic atmosphere.
Я спросил, с кем вы живете?
And I said, who's living with you? Who do you live
with? Она
говорит,
у меня есть сын,
she said, I have a son who was once a Christian,
но потом стал идолопоклонником.
But for some reason, he became an idol worshiper.
Он отрекся от Иисуса.
And he, you know, he denied Jesus.
И когда я пришла домой,
and when I came back home that day,
он сказал, это не Бог тебя исцелил.
So after receiving my miracle, I came back home and he said, this is not God who has healed you. And he cursed me.
И я не смогла ходить.
And then after that, I stopped walking again.
И когда я это услышал,
so when I heard that,
я сказал, сегодня вы опять будете ходить, и Иисус победит.
And I told her, today you are going to walk again, you're going to get you're going to get healed, and Jesus is going to win.
И я помолился за нее.
And I prayed for her.
Оказалось, она не крещённая.
Well, it happened that she was not baptized in the spirit. She was not baptized at all.
Пастор принёс таз с водой, и мы крестили её.
So I took a bucket of water and poured on her.
И когда мы молились за нее, что-то из нее вышло.
So when we prayed for her, something departed her.
И она подскочила.
And she jumped up.
И начала бегать по квартире.
And she started running around the flat.
И она была полностью исцелена.
And she was totally made whole.
Потому что мы сделали так. Мы стряхнули это.
Because we shook off the lie.
Которая пришла от этих идолов.
That came from her son, who was an idol worshiper.
И вы знаете, когда они увидели, что Павел не умер uh-huh. после этой змеи, uh-huh. и об этом узнал Публий, начальник, самый главный на этом острове, uh-huh. он позвал Павла, чтобы Павел исцелил его отца.
Now when they saw that nothing happened to him, he didn't fall down, he didn't die, and the chief of that island saw that, he invited Paul to come pray for his father.
Сегодня церковь, она должна идти к политикам, к чиновникам и приносить им ответы от Бога.
Today the church needs to go to the government, to the politicians and bring an answer from God.
Но чтобы нас туда позвали, нам нужно стряхнуть.
But for us to be called there, we need to shake off the lie.
Нам нужно показать, что мы перестали верить в какую-то либо ложь.
We should show or prove that we've stopped believing in a certain lie.
Мы должны поверить, что в нас есть помазание и сила Святого Духа.
We should begin to believe that the power of the Holy Spirit decides it is in us.
Освободиться от стереотипов, которые в нашей голове.
We should free ourselves from all kind of mentality.
Люди ждут сегодня ответ от церкви.
People are waiting for answers from the church today.
И они ждут не просто информацию, они ждут реальность.
They are not waiting for
Божьего.
Just information from the church, but they are waiting for true answers that can
они
set them
силу.
Free. They are waiting for the power.
Иисус не сказал, вы примите информацию и понесете эту информацию
Jesus Christ
людям.
Didn't say you would receive information and take the gospel on the earth.
Информацией занимается Google.
Google takes charge of information.
Но Иисус сказал, вы примите силу.
But Jesus Christ said, and you receive power.
И вы принесете эту силу людям.
And you will bring that power to the people.
И апостол Павел сказал, что царство Божье, оно не просто в информации, не просто в словах, оно в силе.
And Paul said, the kingdom of God is not just about words or information. The kingdom of God is in the power of God.
Можно попросить прославление?
Can we have the worship group, please?
Player, Kevin. Yeah, Kevin.
Kelvin.
Давайте поклопаем.
Yeah, can you put your hands together for Kelvin? Put your hands together for
Kelvin. Слушайте, слушайте. И когда Публий позвал Павла, чтобы он помолился за его отца, Павел возложил на него руку, и отец Публия был исцелен.
Now the chief of that island invited Paul to pray for his father. When Paul prayed for him, he was healed.
Та рука, за которую укусила змея, эта же рука легла на больное тело отца Публия, и он был исцелен.
The same hand that was bitten by the snake was the same hand that was laid on the father, the chief of that island, and he was healed.
Наша задача — стряхнуть сегодня всякую ложь. и пойти к таким, как отец Публия, свободным, и исцелить их.
Our responsibility is to shake off that lie and go and heal people like that, the father of the chief of that island.
Это ложь о нас самих.
That lie is about us.
Мы поверили в ложь, что мы не можем делать то, что делал Иисус.
We've believed in a lie that we cannot do what Jesus did.
Мы оставили в прошлом чудеса, которые делал Иисус.
We've set behind us all the miracles that Jesus Christ did.
Для нас сегодня удивительно, чтобы кто-то встал с коляски и пошел.
Today is so surprising to us that someone can stand up from a wheelchair and walk.
Но во времена Иисуса, когда Иисус служил, это не было чем-то удивительным.
But in the era of Jesus, it wasn't something surprising.
Это было постоянно.
It was normal.
Когда служили его ученики, это было постоянно.
When his disciples taught and ministered, it was normal.
И сегодня это тоже должно быть постоянно.
And today it should be a normal thing.
Вы хотите, чтобы в вашу церковь пришло много людей?
Do you want a lot of people to come to your church?
Вы хотите этого?
Do you want that?
Вы хотите этого?
Do you want that?
Когда Павел помолился за отца Публия, и он был исцелен, все потом, все на острове стали приходить Павлу и исцелялись от болезни.
Now when Paul healed the father of the chief of that island, it says that everyone in that island came to Paul and they were healed.
Весь остров пришел в движение.
The whole island was in a revival.
Просто потому что Павел исцелил одного человека.
Why? Because Paul just healed one person.
И вы знаете, что сегодня на Мальте нет вообще ядовитых змей.
Now, do you know, in Malta today, that island, they don't have any poisonous snake anymore.
И жители Мальты верят в то, что когда Павел стряхнул ту змею, все змеи исчезли на этом острове.
So the inhabitants of Malta, the island, believe that when Paul shook off that snake into the fire, that was the last poisonous snake that lived or survived on that island.
Нам не надо ждать, что сегодня все люди в Окале стряхнут змею.
Now, we do not need everyone in Окале today to shake off the snakes.
Достаточно нам сделать это сегодня.
It's more than enough for us to take that step.
Достаточно церкви сегодня стряхнуть.
It's more than enough for the church today to take that step and shake off the snake.
И войти в ту силу, которую дал нам Святой Дух.
And enter into that power that is given to us by the Holy Spirit.
Вы знаете, когда Адам с Евой были в Эдемском саду.
Now, you know, when Adam and Eve were in the Garden of Eden,
змей пришел к ним.
The snake came to them.
И вцепился.
And he, you know, bit them.
Он посеял ложь во все человечество.
So he showed a lie in humanity.
И мы сегодня живем в последствиях этой лжи.
And we are living out of that lie.
Впоследствии греха Адама и Евы.
So we are living off the repercussion of the lie of Adam and Eve.
Так сильно схватил человечество.
Because the snake had a great grip.
Это стало передаваться из поколения в поколение.
It had a great grip on human that it was passed off from one generation to another.
Но 2000 лет назад.
But 2000 years ago.
Пришел Иисус.
Jesus Christ came.
И когда он висел на кресте.
And when he was on the cross, hanging on the cross,
этот же змей,
that same snake,
вцепился в его руку, в левую руку,
it stung his left hand,
в правую руку,
his right hand,
он вцепился в его ноги,
his foot,
он сковал его, и Иисус кричал на кресте от боли,
and Jesus Christ was yelling on the cross,
он понес весь яд, который был в нас с вами.
He carried all the venom that was in all of us.
Он понес все наши грехи.
He took away all our sins.
Все наши болезни.
He took away all our sicknesses.
И вы знаете, дьявол думал, что он глубоко вцепился.
And you know, the devil thought that he went deep right into Jesus.
И он думал, что он уничтожает Иисуса.
And he thought he was destroying Jesus.
Но вы знаете, через три дня после того, как Иисуса распяли. Знаете, что сделал Иисус? Он стряхнул это.
Now, after 3 days, just after Jesus Christ was crucified, when he resurrected, he shook off all the lies and the venoms. He shook it off.
И он стряхнул не просто свою змею. Он стряхнул твою змею.
Not just only his own snake, but our snakes.
Он стряхнул мою змею.
He shook away my own snake.
Он стряхнул с нас всякую ложь.
He shook away all kinds of lies.
И когда женщины шли, чтобы помазать его елеем,
and when the women came to anoint his
body, и они подошли к гробу,
and when they came to the terminal,
знаете, что они там увидели?
Do you know what they saw?
Ничего.
Nothing.
Ничего не увидели.
Nothing.
А знаете, почему они ничего там не увидели?
You know why?
Потому что Иисус воскрес.
Because Jesus was resurrected.
Потому что Иисус воскрес из мертвых.
Because Jesus resurrected from the dead.
Потому что он не позволил смерти удержать его.
Because he did not allow,
потому что та змея, которая укусила его, она не смогла его удержать.
Because even the snake bit him, it could not contain him.
И когда Иисус встретился со своими учениками,
and when Jesus Christ met his disciples,
он им сказал,
he said,
стряхните это.
Shake it off.
Стряхните.
Shake it off.
Я стряхнул это для вас. Давайте сделаем это вместе.
So let's do it all together. Let's do it together.
Стряхните всякую ложь.
Shake away all the lie.
И вы знаете, как с Павлом,
you know, just the same as Paul,
что никого не осталось, ни одной змеи не осталось ядовитой на Мальте.
And not even one snake was remaining in Malta as an island.
Так же, когда Иисус стряхнул все наши грехи.
Same thing when Jesus Christ shook away all our sins.
Больше грехи не имеют силы.
Sin has no authority and power over us.
Знаете, почему грешат христиане?
Do you know why Christians, sin?
Потому что они верят в ложь.
Because they believe a lie about themselves.
Как только мы перестаем верить в эту ложь,
they believe in a lie about the Psalms. It's time for us to stop believing in that lie.
Мы перестаем грешить.
When we stop believing in that lie, we stop sinning. We begin to believe.
Hallelujah. Пастор Кевин, мог бы ты спеть песню про вот эту атмосферу, ну вот, которую он последнюю пел?
Pastor Kelvin, please, could you play the last song you sang about the atmosphere, the last song? Yeah.
Я хочу вас вдохновить сегодня.
I want to encourage you today.
В каком бы состоянии вы сегодня находились?
No matter what condition you are in right now.
Сегодня пришло время разрушить всякую ложь.
Today is a day to destroy all lies.
О вас.
About yourself.
Пришло время стряхнуть всякую ложь.
The time has come for you to shake off every kind of lie.
Пришло время освободиться.
It's a time to be delivered.
Потому что ваше призвание, оно не меньше, чем у Павла. Оно не меньше, чем у Иисуса.
Because your calling and your destiny is not lesser than that of Paul or Jesus.
У вас такое же призвание, как у Иисуса.
You have the same calling like that of Jesus.
Проповедовать Евангелие.
Preach the gospel.
В силе Святого Духа.
With the power of the Holy Spirit.
Принести людям освобождение.
Bring freedom to people, set them free.
Забрать всех этих змей из вашего города, из вашей страны.
To take away and destroy all the snakes and serpents from your city and your country.
И принести победу.
And bring about a victory.
Вам, американцам, мне кажется, больше ничего не нужно, у вас уже все есть.
You Americans, that's all you need. Every other thing you already have.
У вас одна из лучших экономик во всем мире.
You have one of the best economics in the world.
У вас на каждом шагу церкви.
At every corner you have a church.
Но людям все равно нужен реальный Иисус.
But people need the real Jesus.
Все равно нужен Иисус.
They need the real Jesus.
Люди могут достигнуть больших вершин.
People can reach the heights.
Но на этой вершине они могут остановиться и понять, у меня нет ничего.
That they could reach the highest of every kind of success, but at that top they would understand, I don't have anything.
Потому что людям нужен Иисус.
Because people need Jesus.
Настоящий Иисус.
A real Jesus.
Я хочу позвать людей.
Now I want to invite those.
Помолиться за тех, кто хочет сегодня стряхнуть это.
I want to invite those today who want to get free of that lie. You want to shake it off. Shake off the lie.
Если вы хотите сегодня вернуться, войти в силу Божью, чтобы пережить это помазание, выходите вперед, мы помолимся за вас.
If you want to get free today and enter into the power of God and His anointing, please you can come and we pray for you.
как ты сказал?
What, did I say that right? Okay.
If you want, if you don't want.
It's not a must, you know, if you want it.
Вам не обязательно оставаться в том, в чем вы находитесь. Вам не обязательно быть в том, в чем вы находитесь.
So it is not a must for you to remain in that situation that you are in right now.
Есть другая жизнь, другая реальность.
There is another life, a different reality.
Реальный Иисус.
The real Jesus.
Реальная свобода.
Real freedom.
Что бы вы ни натворили.
No matter what you have done.
Сегодня.
Today.
Это потеряет силу.
You're going to lose it all.
Сегодня вы можете войти в новый сезон своей жизни.
Because today you can get into a new season in your life.
Я говорю не просто о грехах, которые мы оставили.
I'm not talking about the sins that we stop. I mean, our sins.
Я говорю о совсем другой жизни.
I'm talking about a different life entirely.
Я говорю о том, что когда ты будешь возлагать руки на больных, они будут исцеляться.
I'm talking about the fact that when you lay your hands on the sick, they get healed.
Я говорю о жизни, когда ты будешь говорить от Бога слова людям.
I'm talking about a life that you're going to speak to people out of the presence of God.
Когда ты будешь освобождать людей от бесов.
When you're going to free people out from all kinds of demons.
Когда ты будешь приносить реальное царство Божье.
When you're going to bring a reality of God's presence here on earth.
Проблема многих христиан, что мы хотим попасть на небеса.
The problem of most Christians is like we all want to go into heaven.
И вся наша жизнь превращается в то, чтобы попасть на небеса, на небеса.
In all our lives, I mean, our lives is all hovering around the fact that we want to go into heaven.
Но нам нужно сегодня принести небеса на землю.
But what we need to do is to bring heaven here on earth.
Небеса на землю.
Heaven on earth.
То, что есть у Бога на небесах для людей, принести на землю.
What God got in heaven, we bring it here on earth.
Trevor, иди сюда.
Trevor, can you come up here, please?
Иди сюда. Я кое-что еще покажу.
So I'm going to show you guys one more thing.
Я кое-что еще покажу. Что мы сделаем сейчас?
So this is what we're going to do.
О чем будет наша молитва?
This is what we're going to pray about.
Знаете о чем? Иногда мы позволяем Иисусу коснуться нас вот так.
So sometimes we allow Jesus to have a little hold of us.
Попробуй пойти в другую сторону.
Now try to come, walk up to me, walk towards me.
Oh. И мы так быстро теряем это присутствие.
And we kind of lose that presence of Jesus so easily.
Давайте сегодня вместо этой змеи, которая вцепилась в нас, стряхнем это и позволим Иисусу схватить.
So this is what we're going to do. Instead of that snake or that lie which has had a hold of us, we're going to replace that hold with Jesus.
И теперь, если ты даже попробуешь пойти в другую сторону, сделать что-то не так, то ты не сможешь это сделать.
So now, when Jesus got a hold of you, even if you try to do something else, go somewhere else, you can't do it.
Trevor, try. No. I love you. I love you. Come on.
So even if you try to go away, go astray, Jesus Christ is going to bring you back. You can't go anywhere from Jesus. When you allow Jesus have a whole strong of you, you can't get away from His presence. No matter how you try it, you can't go anywhere.
Потому что ты позволил Иисусу схватить тебя.
Because you have allowed Jesus to have a hold of you.
Потому что ты позволил ему схватить тебя, и он будет держать тебя до конца.
Because you have allowed Jesus to have a hold of you and he's going to hold you forever.
Но он не только будет держать тебя до конца.
He's not going to hold you only forever.
Он поведет тебя. Он поведет тебя к людям.
He will lead you to people. He will lead you to nations. He will lead you to different nations. And he's going to save a lot of people through you. He will heal people through you. You will bring light in the darkness.
Ты принесешь свет в любую тьму.
You will bring light in any darkness because Jesus is going to walk with you. Because you allow him to hold you. Because you allow him to have a hold of you. And he says, I will never forsake you. I will never leave you.
Hallelujah. Are you ready? Может, вы хотите домой?
Maybe after that you want to go home?
No?
No?
Okay. Can we sing? Спасибо тебе, Дух Святой. Давайте закроем глаза.
So can we please close our eyes?
Flood this place, fill the atmosphere.
Дух Святой, спасибо.
Holy Spirit, thank you.
На этом месте.
At this place.
Ты разрушаешь всякую ложь.
You're going to destroy every lie.
В которую мы поверили.
That we believed in.
И мы соглашаемся с тобой.
And we agree with you.
Чтобы прямо сейчас.
That right now.
Всякая ложь.
Every lie.
Которая парализовала нас.
That has paralyzed us.
Мы сегодня хотим стряхнуть это.
Today we want to shake off every lie that has paralyzed us.
Мы хотим, чтобы это ушло из нашей жизни.
We want that lie to depart from our lives.
Мы хотим, чтобы ты вцепился в нас.
We want you to have a hold of us.
Мы хотим свободы.
We want freedom.
Мы хотим силы.
We want power.
Во имя Иисуса Христа.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.